In this tutorial, we will read CSV data, create points, and write them to PostGIS. We will also examine some of the PostGIS Writer parameters for table handling, specifically the create, drop, and truncate table options. Here is our source CSV data of downtown public art locations, which is comma delimited. We will use the latitude and longitude columns to create points. We will write the points to a PostGIS database on an Amazon EC2 machine into a schema called FME Data 2015. Create a new workspace in FME Workbench. Drag the CSV file onto the canvas. The format and dataset are automatically set. Click on Parameters and double-check that the file preview is correct. Setting the longitude and latitude to an X and Y coordinate type allows FME to create points as it reads the data. Also, within the reader dialog, let's set a coordinate system for the points. Select a lat-long WGS84 coordinate system. Now let's add a PostGIS writer. From the Writer's menu, select Add Writer. Select PostGIS for the format. If you already have a database connection set up, you may use it. Otherwise, you can select Embed Connection Parameters and type them in. Notice the default table creation parameters regarding the spatial column and the attribute case. We will use these default values. Click OK to dismiss the dialog boxes. Connect the source and destination. Now open the PostGIS destination feature type properties. We will change the table name to Downtown Public Art. We also need to set the table qualifier to our schema FME Data 2015. Click on the Format Parameters tab. A feature operation, Insert, and Table Handling, Create if needed, is required. This means if the table does not exist, then FME will create it. If it does exist, FME will write to the existing table. We will try the drop and truncate options shortly. It's obvious that the attributes are not mapped because of the red arrows on the destination attributes. A quick way to deal with these is to right-click on the connection and select the Replace Link with Attribute Manager option. Inside the properties of the Attribute Manager, map the mixed case to the lowercase attributes. Go ahead and run the workspace. There are 114 features that have been written to a new table in PostGIS. Right-click on the destination and choose Inspect. Data is read directly from the PostGIS table by the data inspector, and we can confirm that we have points in the table. If we ran this workspace again, FME would load another 114 points into the same table, because our table handling writer parameter was set to create if needed. If we need to completely reload data into the same table, we would select the truncate existing table handling option. Go ahead and run the workspace. We still have the data inspector open, so just hit the refresh button to read from the table again. We can confirm that we have 114 points and not 228. This confirms that the truncate did in fact happen. We can also confirm that the truncate took place in the log file. If we decided to rename our longitude and latitude columns to long and lat, we could change it here in the user attributes and also in the attribute manager. The schema no longer matches the existing table in PostGIS, so dropping the existing table and creating a new one makes sense. Go ahead and run the workspace again. The log file confirms that FME has dropped and created the table. Inspecting the table again confirms that the table was created with the new schema.